The question is simple. Is a person in a coma and on life support a human? Is that person a person? Most people, if not all people, would say, yeah, they're human, they're a person. But according to some, and I quote, an individual is not a person unless he has an IQ of at least 40, is self-aware, has self-control, with a sense of time and an ability to relate to others. Hey, a person in a coma isn't self-aware. They probably won't react to external stimuli. They don't have a sense of time, and they certainly can't relate to others in that state. But does that mean that they aren't human? I'm gonna hope that you said no, okay? If someone's personhood is completely reliant upon their current capacities, then anyone who is sleeping is not a person, right? Okay, let's move on. Let's talk about dead people. Medically, a human being is considered dead when the electrical activity in the brain ceases. In addition to the stopping of the heart and the stopping of the breathing. Now let's reverse that to see what defines life. When there is brain activity, when the human is respirating, and when the heart is beating and there is a pulse. Alright, you might see where this is going. Pregnancy can be detected as early as 2 to 3 weeks after the fertilization. The fertilized egg implants itself on the uterus around week 3 to 4. By weeks 5 and 6, the baby's heart is beating and buds that will be arms and legs begin forming. By week 7 or 8, fingers and toes develop and the arms are bent at the elbows. Starting to seem kind of like a human, huh? Now, around week 8, movements can be detected and the child begins to detect stimuli. Weeks 9 and 10, now PlannedParenthood.org starts referring to the baby as a fetus. The child is absorbing nutrients from the mom's bloodstream as well as oxygen. This is when they begin to make breathing movements, practicing for the outside world, I suppose. Weeks 11 and 12, the baby has fingers, toes, the bones are hardening, skin and fingernails are growing, and the sex organs begin to grow. This is also when brain activity begins. Weeks 13 and 14, the sex organs can be identified and hair begins to grow. Weeks 15 and 16, the mom might start feeling the baby move, and if the child has female sex organs, hundreds of thousands of eggs are forming in their ovaries. Weeks 17 and 18, the baby begins to feel pain. And around week 20, the baby can suck its thumb and respond to sounds. Now by the third trimester, REM indicates that the baby might be dreaming. At week 28, the eyelids are no longer fused together. In weeks 33 through 34, the eyes are developed enough for the pupils to move according to the amount of light. Weeks 37 and 38, the baby can have a firm grasp. And we all know, week 39 to 40 means that the baby is free. Now that you know all of that, tell me, when does the egg and the sperm become a human? By week 6, the heart is beating. It's beating. The baby is alive and its heart is moving. Week 10, the baby is absorbing things that mom gave them and gets rid of waste. Week 11, there is brain activity. It's thinking. Week 12, the baby is moving. But it's still not a human, right? Still not alive. Week 18, they can feel pain. And then it's sucking its thumb and dreaming and sensing light. Alright. So the abortion pill is used up to week 8. And the in-clinic abortion procedures are done anytime after that. Now, I'll let you go look up all the info about the different ways to have an abortion, because I'm not going to talk about that right now. But decide, when does an egg fertilized with a sperm that is developing into a human body become a human? Were you ever a baby in the womb? Were you ever any less than yourself while you were growing up? Is a bigger man more of a human than a smaller man? Is an old lady using a respirator any less of a human than a toddler who is learning to walk? Is a man born without arms and legs not a man? Is your great-great-great-grandma who is in the grave not a person? I hope you find all the answers you are looking for. Just, first, do some research and think. Something has to change.